In August 2013, Elon Musk unveiled his plans to create Hyperloop, a visionary project that would revolutionize public transport as we know it. Hyperloop promised to be a high-speed mode of transportation that would be faster than commercial planes, immune to weather conditions, and completely run on renewable energy. But almost a decade after Musk's announcement and several different companies and organizations working on the concept, what has actually been done to make this vision a reality? Will Hyperloop ever become a reality? Or is it just another futuristic pipe dream that's never going to happen? Let's find out. Currently, only 3.2% of our viewers are subscribed to our channel. So if you enjoy our videos, make sure to click that button. In case you've already forgotten about Hyperloop, here's a quick recap about this futuristic technology. The idea for an ultra-high-speed mode of transportation using vacuum tunnels wasn't actually conceived by Elon Musk. In reality, the concept goes as far back as 1799 to an English mechanical engineer named George Mendhurst, who patented a railway system that could transport passengers and cargo at high speeds through pressurized tubes. The concept would eventually become a series of different inventions under different names, such as Vactrain, Atmospheric Rail, Pneumatic Railway, and finally, Musk's Hyperloop. Although slightly different from each other, what all these things have in common is the idea of propelling trains or pods inside of an evacuated tube or tunnel. This technique would drastically reduce the amount of friction and air resistance that would have otherwise caused drag and slowed down any moving object within. This reduced air resistance would have theoretically made it possible for this technology to transport people at hypersonic speeds. Musk's Hyperloop builds upon this same idea and consists of three main elements. The first one is a sealed tube or tunnel that would run either above or below ground. This tube will run in a partial vacuum to allow minimal drag for passenger pods to run at high speeds. The second element will be the pods themselves, which will ferry passengers in a pressurized environment that contrasts the tubes. Finally, Musk's plan calls for the inclusion of specially made terminals that would handle the flow of passengers to and from pressurized pods. These terminals will also have to be able to contain the low-pressure environment of the tubes as the pods enter and exit from the station. In Musk's 2013 white paper, entitled Hyperloop Alpha, he detailed his plans to create a Hyperloop track that would run from Los Angeles to San Francisco in a route that would roughly follow the Interstate 5 highway in a straight line. This proposed system, according to Musk, would cut the usual 6-hour drive from LA to San Fran to just over half an hour, with a projected top speed of more than 1,200 kilometers per hour, or nearly the speed of sound. Plans for other routes have been raised over the past 10 years by other companies that are behind the current development of Hyperloop. Some of these routes include the Boring Company's Washington, D.C. to New York, Hyperloop One's Chicago to Columbus to Pittsburgh, TransPod's Calgary to Edmonton, and Hyperloop TT's Abu Dhabi to Dubai. Before we dive deep into what happened with these proposed Hyperloops, we want to take a brief moment to thank Surfshark VPN for sponsoring this video. Did you know that websites often charge different prices based on your location? With Surfshark VPN, you can easily change your virtual location by connecting to one of over 3,200 servers in over 100 countries. Turn on Surfshark VPN to change your virtual location, and you can get the best deals. And it also helps you to stay safe on the internet. When you don't protect your online data, hackers can easily steal your passwords, credit card numbers, and personal information, especially during internet banking. Surfshark VPN helps you stay safe, even when you're browsing with your phone. With our promo code TOPLUXURY, or by clicking the first link in the description, you can check out their service and get 83% off, plus 3 months for free. And by the way, with one subscription, you can use as many devices as you want, and even share the account with your friends. Thank you for supporting our videos. Now, let's get back to the Hyperloop. When Musk first went public with his plans for the Hyperloop in 2013, he did so in a way that encouraged other people to improve upon his ideas.
Something that I think could solve the goddamn traffic problem. Yeah.
In addition, the Hyperloop Alpha, worked on by both Tesla and SpaceX, was even released as an open source design that's free for anyone to use, modify, and improve however they see fit. By 2015, SpaceX even opened a 1.6 kilometer test track in Hawthorne, which was subsequently used to test pod designs created by various organizations and universities in an annual design competition sponsored by the company. One of these organizations is Hyperloop One, arguably the world's leader when it comes to Hyperloop technologies. The company was founded in 2014 and was previously known as Virgin Hyperloop One. Their mission was to bring the Hyperloop concept into reality. Although the company has made major technical changes to the initial design in Musk's 2013 proposal, the core concept of transporting pressurized pods in evacuated tubes still remains. Out of all the Hyperloop players, Hyperloop One is probably the company that has accomplished the most when it comes to developing and testing the technology. By October 2016, they had already completed work on a 500-meter test track in Nevada, which they called the Development Loop, or DevLoop for short. In July 2017, they revealed to the public their first prototype pod, called XP-1. This prototype would soon set the world speed record for Hyperloop technologies when it reached a top speed of 387 kilometers per hour in December. In November 2020, with Hyperloop One's second prototype pod, called XP-2, the company reached a major milestone when they conducted the very first human trial of a Hyperloop-like transportation system. The test was conducted on Hyperloop One's Nevada test track and reached a top speed of 172 kilometers per hour. Although this may have been a major development when it comes to Hyperloop technologies, critics have pointed out how Hyperloop One's most recent accomplishments were a far cry to what Hyperloop was originally imagined to be. For one, Hyperloop promised to be a revolutionary concept that would change the very landscape of transportation, the same way the commercial airplane did decades ago. However, what Hyperloop One has accomplished is only a mere fraction of what was initially intended. The top speeds achieved by the company's experimental pods never came close to the Hyperloop's theoretical 1,200 kilometers per hour. It also didn't help that by early 2022, the company announced that it would stop development of a passenger travel Hyperloop system in favor of cargo transport instead. Hyperloop One also laid off more than half its entire staff during this transition, marking a complete stop and non-commitment to further develop Hyperloop for transporting people. Another notable player in Hyperloop technology is Hyperloop Transport Technologies. Hyperloop TT is an American research company that focuses on developing commercial transport systems based on Elon Musk's Hyperloop. While much earlier in their development of systems compared to Hyperloop One, Hyperloop TT is home to the world's first and only full-scale Hyperloop test track located in Toulouse, France. Hyperloop TT is also the very first in the world to showcase a full-scale Hyperloop passenger capsule called the Quintero One. The company also has plans to create a high-speed freight and cargo system in Hamburg, Germany, which they will be calling the Hyperport. This futuristic port will make use of autonomous systems and vehicles to manage and transfer containers across different ports connected by vacuum-sealed tracks. In addition to the previously mentioned plans, Hyperloop TT has also reached an agreement with Abu Dhabi to develop a Hyperloop system that would connect the city with Dubai. But despite all these achievements and agreements, Hyperloop Transport Technologies is still far away from making Musk's 2013 concept a reality. Although the company has created the world's full-scale Hyperloop capsule, there has been little to no news about its current progress. It was initially slated to be ready for passenger use by 2019, but this has never come to fruition. Even the Abu Dhabi track, which was set to be open for commercial use starting in 2023, still seems to be a distant idea. But unlike Hyperloop One, Hyperloop TT seems to be fully committed to creating a Hyperloop system that would transport passengers across vast distances in record time. And only time will tell as to where their research and development will take them. Although currently focused on different projects, Elon Musk and The Boring Company are also dabbling in Hyperloop-like technologies. In 2016, Musk founded The Boring Company, an infrastructure and tunnel boring company that aims to create intercity transit systems called Loops. Musk's Loop promised to bypass the worsening traffic problem in Los Angeles by creating an underground system of tunnels that would be impervious to traffic jams. Unlike Hyperloop, these loops will consist of autonomous electric vehicles that would act as skates that would transport vehicles at speeds of as much as 240 kilometers per hour. One such system has actually been completed and operational by 2021. Albeit in a completely different state than what was initially promised. The Las Vegas Convention Center Loop System was unveiled in April of the same year and was met with harsh online criticism, and probably rightfully so. The finished loop system in Las Vegas consisted of two 2.7 kilometer long tunnels that ran parallel from each other, wherein Teslas would simply drive through. Far from the promised underground system, with autonomous skates ferrying vehicles between stations, the completed Las Vegas loop was basically just an underground highway. To make matters worse, the very problem the loop tried to solve found its way into the tunnels, as seen in an online video that showed a line of Teslas stuck in a traffic jam underground. It is also worth noting how Elon Musk and his companies have gone radio silent for many years about their plans for Hyperloop. In late 2022, it was even reported that the Hyperloop test track found at SpaceX's Hawthorne facility was dismantled and replaced with a parking lot. This has led many to speculate that Musk has personally stopped supporting the project altogether. But just a few days after this news, the Boring Company's official Twitter account posted pictures of what seems to be a new full-scale testing track with the caption that reads, "Full-scale Hyperloop testing has begun." It has also been reported that the Boring Company aims to further expand their Las Vegas loop system and improve upon what is currently built, further solidifying that Musk is still in it to develop the technology. Although Hyperloop may be a promising technology that could reshape the future of transportation, there are many inherent problems that hinder its progress. Ever since Musk released the Hyperloop Alpha in 2013, many people have doubted the feasibility of the concept, citing concerns over safety, engineering, practicality, and economic feasibility. One major roadblock with Hyperloop's concept is the problem of maintaining a near-perfect vacuum over hundreds of kilometers in underground tunnels. It was a major challenge to ensure that the entire track would completely be sealed, as one small leak could bring the whole system to a halt. Another problem with the design is the passenger experience. Critics argue that being inside a small pod traveling through a narrow underground tunnel accelerating at near supersonic speeds would cause extreme noise and discomfort for the passengers. This doesn't even take into account the possibility of emergencies and malfunctions while being in the middle of these underground low-pressure tubes. Finally, it has also been pointed out how Musk's projected cost for the proposed Los Angeles to San Francisco route of less than $6 billion is severely underestimating and miscalculating the actual costs of creating such a system. Do you think Hyperloop will ever become the transportation system of the future, or will it remain only as a futuristic concept that will never be practically feasible? Let us know in the comments down below. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.